Hello all, welcome to the new video. In this video we will see how to find convolution using overlap save method. So in this series I had dealt with how to find convolution using overlap add method. Okay, both overlap add and overlap save method are memory efficient schemes. So whenever we have to find a convolution between two sequences, we usually prefer overlap add method or overlap save method, because both use less memory to calculate the convolution of two sequences. If you use a normal method of convolution, it will take a lot of memory. So both of these are used to reduce the memory, okay? Reduce the number of calculations. It will reduce the calculations involved. Okay. Another note I want to add. Say if x of n, that is one of the sequence, is very large, and y of n another sequence is small, we want to find convolution of these two sequences. Say z of n is equal to x of n convolution with y of n. So in these cases we have to use overlap save method or overlap add method, because it will save memory, it will reduce the calculations. So with this, keeping this in mind, we'll solve an example to find convolution using overlap save method. So let's find the convolution of x of n and h of n using overlap save method. As you can see, x of n is a bit large sequence and h of n is of smaller sequence. So the step one is, let the length of x of n be L. Okay. Length of x of n be L, and length of h of n be n. Okay, first we need to define the length of both sequences, and next step is add n minus 1 zeros. Add n minus 1 zeros to the beginning of h of n sequence. That is, we have n is equal to 3. So n minus 1 means 2 zeros we need to add at the beginning of x of n. Okay, so our new x of n becomes, x of n now becomes 0, 0, 1, 2, 3, 3, 4, and 5. Okay, this is the step 2. So what we have done, we have 0 padded the x of n sequence. Okay, first n minus 1 zeros are added to the beginning of x of n, where h of n is 1, 1, and 1. Now step 3 is divide x of n into k overlapping segments, each of length m. Each of length m, where m is equal to 2n minus 1. So in our case, m will become 5. So what I want to say is, divide this x of n. Its length is now 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. The length of x of n is 8. Okay, it has 8 terms, 8 numbers in it, in that sequence. Now we need to divide x of n into k overlapping segments. K can be, you can start with any count. Okay, k0 means, let the first overlapping segment be x of 0, x0 of n. So step 3 says divide x of n into k overlapping segments each of length m. So since in this case m is equal to 5, our first x0 of n where k is equal to 0 will become 0, 0, 1, 2, 3. As you can see, the length of first is 5. So I have taken first 5 terms of x of n. And in the next step, that is the second segment, I need to take n minus 1 overlapping of x0 n also into the consideration. That is, say our my next x1 of n should have these two terms, okay? So that will become 2, 3 and next 3 terms. That is 3, 4, 5. So in the same way, my x2 of n will be, we need to take these two also in the consideration. That will become 4, 5. Since we have reached the end of the sequence of x of n, we need to add zeros here, because the case the step 3 says that we need to divide x of n into k overlapping segments each of length m, where m is equal to 5. So just add zeros to make the length of this third k equal to 3 of length 5. That is, this segment should also be of length 5. So I'll repeat this step. See, x of n, what we have done, we have 0 padded n minus 1 zeros to the beginning of x of n. Since n equal to 3, n minus 1 will be 2 zeros should be added at the beginning of x of n. So our new x of n becomes 0, 0, 1, 2, double 3, 4, 5. Now divide x of n into k overlapping segments each of length n, where m is equal to 2n minus 1. Since n is equal to 3, m will become 5. We need to divide x of n into k segments each of length 5. So our first segment will become 0, 0, 1, 2, 3. We have to pick the first 5. And in picking the second segment, we need to include n minus 1 overlapping. Last n minus 1 overlapping. That is, n is equal to 3. 3 minus 1 will become 2 overlapping. So these two at the end should be overlapped in the second. Okay. If say n was 4, our h of n was 4, of length 4, then what we have to do? We have to include even this 1 in the x of 1, x1 of n. So what we have done, this 2, 3, 2 and 3 we have included in the second segment. So that will become 2, 3, and the remaining terms we have picked from x of n, 3, 4, 5. In the same way, x of n will become 4, 5. Since we have reached the end of x of n, in order to maintain the segment of length m, we have just added zeros at the end. So this is the step 3, which is of very important step. So let's see what is the step 4. So step 4 is 0 pad h of n to length m. Since in our case m is equal to 5 and h of n is 1, 1, 1, we need to 0 pad h of n to length m. So after 0 padding h of n to length m, our h of n will look like 1, 1, 1, and we need to 0 pad this. That is, m equal to 5. H of n also is of length 5 after 0 padding. So this is the step 4. Now step 5 is perform circular convolution of each segment of x of n with h of n. So in our case we have three segments of x of n. So what step 5 says is we need to find out circular convolution of each segment with h of n. So we need to find out x0 of n convolved with h of n and x1 of n convolved with h of n, and then finally x2 of n convolved with h of n. Since both x0 of n and h of n are of length 5, each segment of h of n are of length 5, and since we have 0 parallel h of n to length m, so all these three will yield some value, say y, say y0, y1, y2. Now we know that since we are performing circular convolution, each y0, y1, y2 will be of length 5. So each will be of length 5. Each will be of length 5. So I will show you how to find out the circular convolution of x0 of n with h of n. So in the similar manner, you need to calculate circular convolution of x1 of n with h of n, x2 of n with h of n. So let's do that. So I'll show you how to find circular convolution of x0 of n with h of n. So first we need to find out linear convolution of these two sequences, and from that we can find out the circular convolution. So our first value is 0, 0, 1, 2, 3, this is h of n, and then by our h of n is 1, 1, 1, 0, 0. So find out the linear convolution of these two sequences, we get one value, okay. So that value is 00136 5300. So linear convolution of x of n with h of n will yield this value, say z of n. This is 0, 0, 1, 3, 6. Y, 3, 0, 0. So, in order to find circular convolution of these two, say y naught of n is the circular convolution, what we have to do? We have to add this part. That is 5300 at the beginning of this z of n. That is what I mean to say is y0 of n will now become 00136. Add this 5300 here. 5300. And ignore this one. So add numerator and denominator. So nothing is there, you can treat it as 0. So our y0 of n will become, which is the circular convolution of x0 of n with h of n, 5, 3, 1, 3, 6. So in the similar fashion, calculate y1 of n and y2 of n. So I have calculated the circular convolution of each segment of x of n with h of n. So I have now three set of values. Now the next step is discard first n minus 1 values in each these three results. Since I know n is equal to 3, n minus 1 will be 2. So discard first 2. first two values in each result. That is, discard this, discard this, and this, discard this. So now our final result will be, say, y of n will have only 1, 3, 6, 8, 10, 12, 9, 5, and 0. So since our first x of n was 1, 2, 3, 3, 4, 5, so h of n was 1, 1, 1. As you can see, x of n, the length of the sequence is 6, h of n is 3. Okay, so we know that the linear convolution of this x of n with h of n should have how many values? 8. So take first 8 values of this y of n. That will become 1, 3, 6, 8, 10, 12, 9, and 5. So this is the convolution of these two sequences using overlap save method. So you can verify this result with the overlap add method which I had done earlier. So both this value will yield same result. In fact, it is the calculation of linear convolution. It is a value of linear convolution but with different method. So this method will have less operations, less multiplications involved in the usual linear convolution method. So this is the final value 1, 3, 6, 8, 10, 12, 9, 5. So the final value has length of 1, 2, 3, 8. Okay. So I think I have explained it in a very slow fashion so that you can understand it. So thanks for watching. Please subscribe to our channel and spread the word. Thank you.